We'll start this session with conversions, that is from hexadecimal to binary as well as hexadecimal to octal. As we have seen how to convert the other form numbers to decimal, and then we have also seen how to convert the binary into the other forms, octal into other forms. Now let us see hexadecimal to the other forms. Okay, can be converted by representing each hex digit by its equivalent 4-bit binary. Okay, so as we know that how to represent hexadecimal numbers, will be from 0 to F. There are totally 15 symbols are used in this hexadecimal representation. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to represent each and every hex digit with the help of 4-bit binary equivalent. Okay, so let us see with an example. FE is the hexadecimal number. Now we have to represent this F by using 4-bit binary, that is 4 ones. And E is nothing but 1110. So here it is, 3 ones and a 0. Okay, so this is how we are going to convert a given hexadecimal number into binary number. Okay, now let us see hexadecimal to octal. Can be converted by representing each hex digit by its equivalent 4-bit binary, as we did now, and group them in 3 bits from right to left. And append zeros at the MSB if required, and write the equivalent octal form. So initially we have to represent the given hexadecimal number in the binary form, and then we have to group 3 bits from the left towards the right. And we have to append zeros at the left if it is required. Okay, so let us see how to do that. So initially I'm representing F, E and 7 in binary form by using 4-bit equivalent. So this is how I have represented, and then I have to group 3 bits from right towards left. So here 3 ones, and then 001, 3 ones, and then 3 ones. Now write its octal equivalent. So 3 ones here is nothing but 7, and then 100 is nothing but 4. Okay, so we will get 7747 in octal representation. Okay, so this is how we are going to convert the given hexadecimal number into binary as well as into octal number. Other forms to decimal. Up to now we did not see how to convert the other form of the numbers like binary, octal and hexadecimal to the decimal form. Okay, now let us see that other form of number system is converted to decimal number by using multiplication algorithm. So here we have to use one algorithm for converting the other form numbers into decimal numbers. Okay, and that algorithm is called as multiplication algorithm. Now let us see how to do that. Multiplication algorithm: multiply the digits or bits by increasing powers of base, that is 2, 8, 16, starting from the right. Okay, then to find the decimal number equivalent, sum those products. So what we have to do is we have to multiply the given numbers or the given digits or bits with the source base in powers of, in the increasing powers. Okay, let us see that. So for example, this is the binary number, and I have to convert this binary number into decimal form. So I have to multiply these bits with the source base, that is 2, in increasing powers. Okay, so here let us see that. So 2 power 0 initially, this is 2 power 0 into 1 plus 2 power 1 into 0 plus 2 power 2 into 1 plus 2 power 3 into 1, and then you have to sum all these values, then you'll get in decimal form. Then you'll get the result in decimal form. In the same way, I took one more example here, which is in octal form. So we have to follow the same procedure, that I have to multiply these digits with the source base in increasing powers. That is 8 power 0 into 6 plus 8 power 1 into 7. Okay, then we have to add these values, and we'll get the result in a decimal form. Okay, one more example which is in hexadecimal form. So here again the same thing, 16 power 0 into B plus 16 power 1 into A, which gives a resultant value, that is 171 in decimal. So this is how we are going to convert the given number which is in binary, octal or else in hexadecimal into decimal forms. Let us see one more example. Convert this binary number to its decimal equivalent. Now this is the binary number which is given, and we have to multiply it with the positional equivalence, that is 2 power 0, 2 power 1 up to 2 power 7. Then I'll be getting the equivalent decimal number, that is 173. Now let us see, up to now we have seen how to convert the integer values into the other forms, but now let us see how to convert the fractional values. Okay, so decimal to other forms is done by using repeated multiplication method. Okay, the fractional part of the decimal number is multiplied by the destination base value, and the integer part of the result is stored after every process. This process is done until fractional part of decimal number becomes zero or up to 5 to 6 precision values. So what we have to do is, we have to here we want to convert a given decimal number into the other forms, that is in fractional part. Okay, so if we have a decimal fractional part, okay, and we want to convert that into any other form, then what we have to do is, we have to multiply the given fractional part with the destination base, okay, and we have to store the integer part, and we have to continue this multiplication process until the decimal number becomes zero or else up to 5 to 6 precision values. Okay, let us see this with an example. So here I took one decimal number, that is 0.201 in decimal to octal. So what is it? We have to multiply this part, that is 201, with the destination base, that is 8. Okay, so multiply 201 with 8, then you'll get this is the result. Now the integer part of the result would be stored. So I have stored this integer part. Now again I have to continue the multiplication process of this result, that is 608 into 8. Then I have got 4 in the integer part, so that should be stored. And again I have multiplied this result, fractional result, with 8. Then I got 6, and again I have multiplied this fractional result with 8, have got 7, and then the fractional result is again multiplied with 8, then I have got 2. So either we have to go with 5 to 6 precision values, or else we have to continue this process until this part becomes 0, until this fractional part or integer part becomes 0. Okay, now after getting all these values, now make a note of those values from the top to bottom in this fashion. Okay, then you'll get the resultant conversion. Now let us see how to convert a binary to octal and a hexadecimal number. Okay, it is similar to that of integer part conversion, but the grouping has to be done from left to right. Append zeros at the right side if required. So we have to follow the same procedure which we have done for binary to octal and hexadecimal in case of integer part. That is, let us take an example here. So here I took one binary number. Now I want to convert this binary number into octal form. So I'm going to represent this I'm going to group them 3-3 bits from left towards right. Okay, so 011 010, and as there is only one bit, so I'm going to append zeros at the right side. Okay, so appending zeros on the right side of the fractional part will not modify the value, so that is why I'm appending zeros or towards the right side. Now I have to represent them in the equivalent octal form. So it is 3, 2, and then a 4. Now we have to follow the same procedure to convert it into hexadecimal value. So initially I have to group 4 bits here, so 0110 and then 1010. Okay, and it should be represented in a hexadecimal form. So this is how we are going to convert a given binary into octal and hexadecimal in case of fractional part. Now let us see how to convert a given octal to binary as well as into hexadecimal. It is again similar to the to that of integer part conversion, but the grouping has to be done from left to right. Append zeros at the right side if required. So we have to follow again the same procedure. Let us see this with an example. So this is given in, or this is represented in, octal form. Now we have to get the equivalent binary form. So represent every digit by using 3-3 bits, that is 010 and then 101. Okay, now I want to convert the same octal into hexadecimal, so represent every digit by using 3-3 bits and then group 4 bits. Okay, then you will get the resultant hexadecimal form. Okay, now let us see how to convert hexadecimal to binary and hexadecimal to octal. It is similar to that of integer part conversion, but the grouping has to be done from left to right, append zeros at the right side if required. So let us see this with an example. So I have took one hexadecimal fractional part, that is 0.AB. Okay, now I have to convert this into binary. So write the 4-bit equivalent of each and every hexadecimal digits. That will give you the resultant binary value. Okay, now if you want to convert this hexadecimal into octal, now again represent them in 4-bit binary. So as you can see here, 1010, 1011. Now group 33 bits from left towards right and append zeros if required. Okay, then you'll get the resultant octal representation of the given hexadecimal representation. Now let us see how to convert the other forms into decimal forms. Multiply the digits or bits by decreasing powers of source base starts from -1, starting from the left. Then to find the decimal number equivalent, sum those products. So what we have to do is we have to multiply in decreasing powers of the source base for the given number. Okay, so let us take an example here, 0.351 in hex to decimal. So here the source base is 16, therefore I have to multiply these digits, I have to multiply these digits in decreasing powers of source base, that is 16 power -1, -2, -3, and so on. Okay, and we have to start this from left, that is from this point. Okay, so here 16 power -1 into 3 plus 16 power -2 into 5 plus 16 power -3 into 1. Now I have to sum all these products, then I'm going to get the resultant decimal value. Okay, so in the same way, if at all the given number is in octal form, then you have to use the base as 8. Instead of 16, you have to substitute with the base 8. If it is given in binary, you have to substitute with the base 2. Okay, so this is how we are going to convert the other forms into the decimal representation. Now let us see our next concept, that is signed binary numbers. Okay, so here, as we know how to represent the negative numbers as well as the positive numbers, but how the computer is going to represent the negative numbers as well as the positive numbers. Okay, let us see that with this concept, that is signed binary numbers. Okay, so what do you mean by unsigned numbers? The numbers without any sign are known as unsigned numbers. So if we are not representing any sign, if we are not using any sign as a prefix to the numbers, then that particular number would be considered as a unsigned numbers. Okay, now what do you mean by signed number? The numbers with any sign are known as signed numbers. So if we are representing any number with a prefix or with a prefix of a plus or else a minus, then that particular number is called as a signed number. Okay, just we are representing the sign. Okay, now the computer is going to use any one of these three methods for representing the sign of a binary number. So one is signed magnitude representation, one's complement representation, and then two's complement representation. Okay, so let us see each of these in detail. Signed magnitude representation, in this method MSB of the binary number represents the sign and the remaining represents the magnitude. Okay, so here for example, if you have a binary number, then the MSB bit of that particular binary number is nothing but the sign, and remaining 7 bits would be considered as the magnitude or as the quantity. Okay, so let us see here, B7, B6, B5, B4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Here B indicates base, and B7 is the sign, and B6 to B0 is magnitude, which represents the quantity. If B7 is 0, it indicates that it is a positive number. Okay, if this particular bit is 0, then it indicates that it is a positive number, and if this particular bit is 1, then it indicates that it is a negative number. Okay, let us see this with an example. So here I have took one binary number whose MSB bit is 0, and the remaining bits are going to represent the quantity. Now here this quantity represents 8, the value 8, therefore it is a positive 8. Okay, and in the same way I took one more example here where the MSB bit is 1 and the remaining bits are going to represent the quantity, therefore it is considered as a -8. Okay, so this is how we are representing any value by using sign magnitude representation. Okay, now let us see the next kind of representation, that is ones complement representation. In this method, each bit is subtracted from one, or it is obtained by replacing ones with zeros and zeros with ones. MSB is 0 for positive number and 1 for negative number. Okay, so what we have to do here is we have to replace the zeros with ones and ones with zeros. Okay, and if the number has the MSB bit as 0, then it would be considered as a positive number, and if the MSB bit is 1, then it would be considered as the negative number. Okay, now here positive number is represented as it is, okay, where the MSB bit is 0. Okay, but in order to represent the negative number, it uses ones complement form, where zeros are replaced with ones and ones are replaced with zeros. As you can see that now the MSB bit here is 1, therefore it is a negative value. Okay, and the quantity here represents the 8. As MSB is 1, it is a negative number. Okay, so this is how we are going to represent a negative number by using ones complement form. Now let us see the next form, that is 2's complement form. 2's complement of a binary number is obtained by adding 1 to the 1's complement number. MSB is 0 for positive number and 1 for negative number. Okay, so positive numbers are represented in the same way with MSB 0, but when it comes to the negative number, then we have to take 1's complement of that particular number. So I have took 1's complement of 8. Now we have to add plus 1 to this 1's complement. Then you'll get the value, which is nothing but the 2's complement of that 8. Okay, as MSB is 1, it is considered as a negative number. Okay, so in case of 2's complement, we represent the negative numbers by first taking the 1's complement and then adding a logic 1. Then the result would be the 2's complement of that particular number. Now let us see binary codes. So digital data is represented, stored and transmitted as a group of binary bits. This group is called binary code. Okay, so actually we represent or store or transmit any kind of information in the form of binary codes. Okay, and or binary bits. So that particular group of bits is called as a binary code. The binary code can be used for representing the number as well as alphanumeric characters. Okay, so we are going to use these binary codes for representing the numbers as well as for representing the alphabets and numerics. Okay, now usage of the binary codes will be depending on the application that we are going to use. For example, if I take a binary code like ASCII, which is mostly used in non-IBM PCs, and in most of the communication ASCII codes will be used. So that depends on the application of these binary codes. Okay, now let us see the classification of those binary codes. So binary codes here are classified into 4 types: weighted codes, non-weighted codes, alphanumeric codes, and then error detecting and correcting codes. Okay, so weighted codes are again classified into 2 types: binary, as we have seen that zeros and ones, and then BCD. Okay, and examples of BCD are 8421, 2421, 5211, and then 4221. So weighted codes are those codes where each and every bit position is given with a particular weight. Okay, as you can see here, now the weight of this particular position is 1, and the weight of this particular position is 2, and the weight of this position is 4, and the weight of this position is 8. Okay, so every bit position would be having its own weight. And non-weighted codes, gray code and X3, that we will see later, and then alphanumeric codes, which are mainly used for representing the alphabets as well as the numerics, and error correction and detection. These are mainly used in case of communication when we want to transfer some data from one place to the other place. There might be a chance of getting noise into that particular message. So in order to detect as well as correct those errors, we would be using these error detection and correcting codes. Okay, let us start our discussion with weighted codes, that is BCD, binary coded decimal. BCD stands for binary coded decimal. A BCD number is a 4-bit binary group that represents one of the 10 decimal digits 0 through 9. So by using these BCD numbers, we can represent the decimal digits 0 to 9 with the help of 4 binary bits. Okay, let us see how to represent that. So I have took 8421, where I'm going to represent decimal number 0 to 9 with the help of 4 binary bits. Okay, so 8, 4, 2, 1, so 0, 0, 0, 0, I want to represent 1, therefore you just put a 1 at the weight 1, then you'll get 1, decimal 1. Okay, if you want to get the decimal equivalent of 2, then you have to put a 1 in the weight or in the position 2. Okay, and if you want to get 3, then you have to put 1s at the weights 2 as well as 1, so you have to add those 2 weights. Okay, so by adding these weights you'd be getting the decimal equivalents. Okay, and this is how we are going to represent the other forms, that is 8421, 2421, x3, biquinary, and 1 out of 10 codes. Okay, we'll see all these codes in the later sessions, but for now we will just concentrate on this 2421. Okay, here the weight of this particular position is 1, and weight of this position is 2, and this position is 4, and weight of this position is 2. Okay, so when you add these weights, then you have to get the decimal equivalent numbers. Okay, now let us see what is this gray code. It is called cyclic or reflected code. In this code, each code group does not differ from its neighbor in more than one bit. So that is why they are called as unit distance codes, where a single bit would be different in the neighborhood groups. Okay, this code is used for input and output devices in digital systems. Okay, let us see how to represent this gray code. So here I am going to represent decimal number 0 to 12 in gray code form. Initially you have to represent this 0 and 1, the decimal two digits, by using 2 bits in gray code, that is 00 and 01, which is similar to the binary representation. Now after representing 0 and decimal digit 0 and 1, okay, with 2 bits, then what you have to do is you have to take the mirror values of this for the next digits, that is 2 and 3. Okay, so if you take the mirror of this 0 and 1, then you'll get 1 and 0, and here it is 00, therefore you just go with 11 at these positions. Okay, now again, in order to get the gray codes for the next decimal digits, that is 4 and 5, take the mirror image of these four bits, then you'll get 0110, and then mirror image of these four bits, so 1100, and then as there are four zeros here, so now we represent with four ones. Okay, in the same way, if you want to get the gray code for the remaining, again you have to go with the mirror images of the LSBs and then put logic ones at the MSBs. Okay, so this is how you are going to convert, you are going to represent the decimal numbers in gray code form. Now let us see how to convert a given binary into gray code form. Write down the binary form of the given decimal number, write the MSB as such, then add the binary digit from left to right at the adjacent position, discard carry if any, write the digit which comes after the addition. Okay, let us see how to do that with an example. So I've took one example, that is 15 in decimal. I've converted it into binary. Now I have to write the MSB as it is. Okay, now this MSB is added with the adjacent bit, and the result should be noted down. Okay, so here 1 plus 1 is 0, and there is a carry of 1. Now that carry is added with the adjacent number, that is 1 plus 1 again, it is 0. Now again there would be a carry. Now that carry is again added with the adjacent bit, so you'll be getting 0 and 1 is carry, and you have to discard the carry, end carry. Okay, hence the resultant gray code is 1000 for 15. Okay, now let us see one more example where the binary should be converted into again gray code. So leftmost bit is written as it is. Now this bit is added with the adjacent bit, therefore sum is 0 and carry is 1. Now that carry is added with the adjacent bit. Now again the sum is 0 and the carry is 1. Now that carry is again added with the adjacent bit. Now here it is, the sum is 1. Now carry is 0, 0 is added with 1, therefore the sum is 1, and carry is 0, 0 is added with 1, therefore the sum is 1. Okay, so this is how you have to convert a given binary into gray code. Okay, now let us see how to convert the given gray code into binary form. Write the given gray code, write the leftmost bit as such, add this bit to the second leftmost bit, write the result, discard the carry, add this result to the next leftmost bit diagonally. Let us see that. Now I've took one example here, that is 1000, which is in gray code form. Now I have to convert it into binary. Okay, so write the MSB bit. Now this MSB bit should be added with the diagonal bit, okay, towards the right side. So 1 plus 0 would be giving you 1. Now again this result should be added with the diagonal bit, therefore you'll be getting one more result, that is 1. Now again this bit should be added with the diagonal bit, then you'll get a logic 1. So this is the final value or final binary value for the given gray code. Now let us see the next kind of code, that is X3 code. Now add 3 to each digit of decimal and convert to 4-bit binary form. Okay, so ABCD code, not 8421 BCD. So here we have to add ABCD code, not 8421. So we have to add plus 3 to the binary or else to the decimal to get, and we have to write the equivalent binary form. Okay, so 0011, here it is 0 in binary, added with 3, then you'll get the X3 code as 0011. Okay, in the same way here 1001 in binary, now added with 3, then you'll get 1100. So this is how we represent X3 codes. Okay, now let us see ASCII code. Now here ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange, and this is mainly used for representing numbers, letters and some special symbols like punctuation marks and control characters. And standard ASCII code is a 7-bit code, so with the help of 7-bit code we can only represent only 127 characters. But now this ASCII has been extended, now it is called as extended ASCII, and its length is 8-bit code, therefore we can represent a total of 256 characters. Extended ASCII adds graphical as well as the mathematical symbols. And the next form of code is EBCDIC, where EBCDIC stands for Extended Binary Coded Decimal for Information Interchange, and this was designed by the IBM, and it is mainly used in IBM PCs, and it is a 8-bit code, so we can represent a group of 256 characters. Okay, thank you.